A lot of people come to me, they want oral medications right away. I want to get better right away. I'm getting ready for the summertime and I don't want ugly toenails anymore. I'm tired of all of this. They want to be on it right away. Well, not so fast. Hello everyone, this is Dr. Kim, America's Holistic Foot Doctor. So far in this video series, we talked all about toenail fungus on the first video. We talked about characteristics, who gets it, and what types of fungus are out there. On the second video, we talked about 6 home remedies you should try at home. Cleaning, drying, soaking, sunbathing, rotating shoes and socks, and going barefoot. Today, I'd like to talk to you about my top 4 medical treatments that I utilize in my medical practice. Almost every one of patients with toenail fungus has already tried many different home remedies or self-treatment before they presented to my office. So they are seeking for stronger, more effective medical treatments. Whether it's grinding or thinning of the nails, topical or oral medications, or laser treatments, they can all add up to be much more effective tools. Let's get right into it. So when you present to my office with a fungal toenail, first thing I do is take a sample from the tip of the nail like this to see if you have fungus. And we send that sample to a laboratory to analyze whether you have fungus, or if you do have fungus, what kind of fungus you have. We talked about 3 different types of fungus: dermatophytes, non-dermatophytes, and yeast infections. So we need to delineate them, and you're going to find out on the next few slides that we're going to get you to use a specific medication for specific fungus you have. And those are different kinds of testing out there. There's first thing that we use is KOH, which is potassium hydroxide testing. It's a stain that makes the fungus more visible, and then that's a very popular test. The currently what we use is PCR testing, polymerase chain reaction testing, which expands the view of the microscope to see what type of fungus, if you do have fungus, and then we can delineate the different type of fungus that we can use, different topical cream or medication to combat the specific fungus. The first treatment that I use is called debridement or removal. Now, so many patients come to me and they have really ugly thick nails, so they say, well, could you just take the nail out and start brand new? Well, it sounds logical. It seems like that would work. I've tried that many times in the past and really didn't work out too well. The nail doesn't grow normally almost 100% of the time because it doesn't have anything to guide the new nail to come out. So when you take the whole nail out, then it's very difficult to make the nail coming out look very nice. So we want to keep the nail. I know it's ugly and it doesn't look good, but you have to keep it the way it is so that when the new nail comes out, it has something to follow and to build a new nail upon. So it is very important not to remove if you don't have to. And then debride the nail. Debriding meaning using tools like this one. I use this very strong, high power, like a drill, to grind the nail down as thin as possible every time I see the patients. I usually see the patients once a month and I grind it down as much as I can. Why? Because when you put the medication in, it'll be able to penetrate now. Because of all the thickness and all the things that are on top of it, it's very difficult for the nail medicine to penetrate into the nail. Also, I tell patients to soak it and make the soaking and other treatment, more natural treatment, which you'll be continue to do, it'll be a lot more effective if you have much thinner nail. And it's gonna look a lot nicer, much faster. So people really like the debridement of a monthly debridement that they come in for. Next treatment, second treatment, is to prescribe topical medications. There are many topical medications, as you can see. Also, there are a lot of over-the-counter medications that are effective as well, but we like much stronger prescription medication, and these are the prescription medications. You probably heard of some of these medications. These 2 are the most common things that I use. Loprox and Penlec are same thing, but it's Penlec's about 10 times stronger, but it's a lot more difficult to use. Now, Loprox is just a cream that you put on twice a day, and then the Penlec has a little brush, and then it's a little oily thing you put on daily on top of one another, and then on the 7th day, you will take that off with alcohol and start brand new. And they're both quite effective. The next one is Jublia and Keratin. Now, I would like to use these medications all the time because these seem to be a lot stronger than these. However, they're very, very costly. And it's so costly that most people cannot afford to use this medication. But if your insurance covers these particular medication, I highly recommend these medications because they're a lot more effective than those two up on top. Now, these four are mostly for dermatophyte, which are most common ones. About 95% of all the fungal nail problem is dermatophyte, so you'll be using these. But if you happen to use non-dermatophyte or yeast infection, which is not very common at all, then you're going to have to use Nizoral, which will be killing the fungus of those species. We're about halfway through the top medical treatments for toenail fungus. If you've enjoyed this video so far or learned something new, leave a word medical in the comments below and be sure to give this video a thumbs up. Next treatment that I use is laser treatment. A lot of people come to me and say, well, I heard that laser works wonders and it's gonna, you know, get rid of all my toenail fungus. Well, that's what I was hoping when I bought the machine about 15 years ago, and I've been using tens of thousands of people, literally. And I've kept track of all the people getting better and not getting better. And I realized that about, with the machine that we have, is about 30 to 35% effective. So one out of three people actually improve their nail just using laser. Obviously, we try to use combination of the topical and your home remedies and all this together combined, so it's a lot more effective at the end. But the laser treatment alone doesn't quite do the job. So I want you to be really clear that laser is not solution to all toenail fungus problem. Well, as you can see, the beam is on the nail. It's supposed to kill the fungus, but not the nail. I don't know how that does it because of the certain frequency that they have, but that's what they claim that it does. And it really doesn't deform your nails, but a lot of time it doesn't respond. Unfortunately, I hate to tell you like this, but if you are not healthy or if you're older patients, it just does not work for you, okay? I've tried it on a lot of younger people who injured their nails or got fungus infection. And when I do it with them, within months, they really improve dramatically. However, when I do it on anybody older, 50 or 60 or 70 or patients, it really doesn't work that well. So unfortunately, it doesn't work for everybody. It's a very good procedure, however, it really doesn't help everybody, unfortunately. And a lot of people ask, does that really hurt? Well, it gets a little hot, so I allow the patients to tolerate as much as possible, and then I stop when it gets too hot, and then I rest a little, and then I keep going. I have to give certain amount of joules, we call them the energy, into the nail. For each toenail is a different amount of joules you have to put in, and we keep track of all of that, and we do it monthly for about 6 months, and then we do every other month for a few more treatments. So it takes about a year or so to finish all the laser treatment as well. And unfortunately, insurances don't pay for this service, because they call it experimental, so we have to charge you a cash price for this particular treatment plan. Next one, the most powerful out of all, is the oral medications. A lot of people come to me, they want oral medications right away. I want to get better right away. I'm getting ready for the summertime, and I don't want ugly toenails anymore. I'm tired of all of this. They want to be on it right away. Well, not so fast, because this oral medication, even though it's very powerful and very effective, it has a lot of side effects, just like all the other medications, because it taxes your liver, so that it inflames the liver. It makes your liver enzymes kind of go up quite a bit sometimes. So you have to be really cautious if you're the right person to use its medications or not. I'm telling everybody to use all the home remedies and all the soaking and cleaning and all those things you do. And then you do the laser and you use the topical. And then when things don't work out in about 6 months to 8 months, that's when I started discussing about oral medication if you qualify. What makes you qualify? You have to be a really healthy person. You cannot be on a lot of medication. You cannot be over 60 or 70 years old. And you have other medical issues such as diabetes, you have hypertension, you have multiple medications. Those are very difficult people to take, because if you're already taking a lot of medications and then you take more medication to help your toenail, and it's going to really, unfortunately, it's going to really mess up your liver. So I highly advise against a lot of not so healthy people to take the oral medication, but I take their liver panel test through the blood to make sure your liver enzymes are really, really good shape. And then we start the medication. We monitor every month. This particular medications are 3 months dosage. You just take one a day. And then it's quite convenient. However, it can really put a lot of pressure on your liver, such as having diarrhea or stomach problems, or you know, some people have constipation and a lot of other gut issues you may get because it taxes on your internal system. So Lamisil and Spironax, especially Lamisil, is the most common thing that I use. It's a one-a-day regimen. I tell people to quit drinking. You have to drink a lot of water. You have to rest. You really can't be stressed too much. So it's very important to keep your liver in good shape before you start the medication. And throughout the whole time, I'll be checking your liver enzyme level through blood to make sure your liver enzymes are not fluctuating, which is a big problem, okay? And sometimes if you have non-dimerophytes or yeast infection, then you would use Diflucan instead of these other two medications. So that's how we treat your toenail problem when you present it to my office. And these are in the sequence that I use. And obviously, I want to emphasize again, but this oral medication is only limited to those who qualify to take medications. Be sure to like this video if you found it interesting or learned something new. And if you think someone else will enjoy it, be sure to send it to them. My next video in my toenail fungus series is all about how the food you're eating might be causing your toenail fungus. You won't want to miss it. Don't forget to follow me on my other social media channels, including Instagram and Facebook, to stay updated on everything happening on my channel. Until next time, be educated, get empowered, encourage others today.